Hi, Ziana from transvoicelessons.com, and today I want to explain how and why changing our voice works, okay? So first off, this is not a mystery. It is not even confusing. I'm going to explain it to you very simply. Okay, basically, when you make something bigger, it causes it to sound darker, okay? And when you make something smaller, it causes it to sound brighter, thus more feminine. Now, this is the most fundamental of all of it. There are two things that we have to understand. One, that is that when we produce a pitch, we're actually producing an infinite series of pitches upwards at smaller ratios, okay? This is called the harmonic series, and it's present in all things that produce a stable oscillating pitch, whether it's a flute or a body or a piano or a guitar or whatever, okay? Now, the other thing is that depending on the size of the container that sound exists inside, it will drive a resonant frequency up or down. So think about like a 2-liter jug, okay? If you have a 2-liter jug and it's empty, you blow into it, hoo, hoo. You fill it up with water, hoo, hoo. It's a higher pitch, right? So the bigger the space is, the lower the resonant frequency drops. And the smaller the space is, the higher the resonant frequency climbs, okay? Now, if we apply this to voice, it makes a lot of sense. So I'm talking.
Okay, so testosterone causes our vocal tract length to be bigger, okay? So basically, we overcome this by slowly starting to shrink the vocal tract length so that we drive the resonant frequency higher and higher up our overtone stack, okay? So when we emphasize the higher overtone, we sound feminine. And when we emphasize
the lower frequency, we sound more masculine.
Okay, so it's very simple. Now, one thing that you have to understand about this is that it is additive and subtractive. So watch.
So I've got like plus 2.
So let's just say I have plus 2 centimeters there in my throat. I'm actually talking like this the whole time.
And then I add the 2 centimeters and I sound like that, okay? It's additive. Watch. If I add the 2 centimeters here.
And then I add another centimeter there.
Okay, so now you're dealing with that.
You're looking at plus 5, plus 6 centimeters onto your original vocal tract length, okay? Which is why the sound sounds so dark. Now, the opposite's true. I can reduce 2 here and reduce 2 here, and then you get a more feminine sound. So if I'm talking like this, and then I simply reduce the 2 centimeters here, and then I'm speaking, and I simply reduce the 2 centimeters here, you can hear that I sound extremely feminine, because at that point, I'm reducing my vocal tract length so much that I am below the female average, okay? And it doesn't matter what pitch you speak at. It's all about this resonant frequency of your vocal tract, okay? Now watch, I'll even demonstrate.
So, if I do like my voice or whatever, and I slowly start to bring the pitch down, but I keep everything else the same, you can hear how it's very buzzy and very brassy. And then if I simply slide the pitch back up, all that weirdness disappears, okay? That's because when I brought the pitch down, I was emphasizing the higher overtones, which is why it sounded buzzy and brassy. And then when I slid the pitch back up, all of those higher overtones made sense relative to our foundation, okay? So this is about space. Nothing more, nothing less. Now, I can actually cancel out effects. If I take away space here in my throat, but I make my face big, the result will be near zero sum. Now, this is one of the biggest issues that people who feel they have their voice mostly under control have. They're speaking, they've got good laryngeal control, they don't think about their mouth space, and so their mouth gets too big, and it cancels out part of the effects of their larynx, causing them to fall down to the next overtone and sound clocky, okay? That's really what's going on here. Now, so how can we actually change the space? Well, one, with the larynx, right?
So if I'm here and I slowly start to bring the larynx up, you can hear the influence of it, and my sound is pretty strong, right? Okay, it almost sounds like I inhaled helium.
But there's another aspect to this. We can also control space inside of our mouth. And we do this with the consonants and the vowel, okay? So basically, When you make a darker vowel, versus e, you literally have more geometric space inside your mouth. Okay, that's what darkness versus brightness is. It's space. Now, we can control via the vowel and the consonants how much space we allow to build up in our mouth. So we essentially have two dials. We have like a laryngeal dial, and we can dial that up or down. And we have like an oral cavity dial, and we can make more oral cavity space or less. And of course, we want less if we're going feminine. But for female to males, they're looking for more space. So essentially, it's all about controlling your mouth and your larynx, and that's really it. Okay? It's really that simple. And if you feel you need any more help with this, please reach out to me. I plan to make more videos and stuff, but you know how dysphoria goes. I don't know. I don't know. All right. Take care.